So in recent times, particularly on the internet, our social media, I have come across several videos, not one, not two, from men and women, especially the married folks, that come up on the internet space to address or talk about, on the part of the men, how our women who relocate abroad with their spouses turn out to be very wicked, mean, and at the end of the day, go through things that are unthinkable. Most times, the relationship or marriage end up in divorce. How these women go outside, relocate abroad, and take advantage of the law and use it against them as men. I've seen several videos like this making rounds on the internet, on the social media. And from the angle of the women, I have seen women come out, especially the married folks as well, talk about how their partners, their husbands, when they are in Nigeria, who are mean, who are very frustrating, toxic, ridiculous, travel out or relocate abroad and turn a new leaf of living, you know, a good life, of thereby treating these their wives, their partners, in the very best way and form, because they think they know better what the law says. Now, in order for us to address this properly, let's look at certain factors, certain points that should be considered to know why these things happen, to know whose fault it is, and to know where it is coming. Marriages in Nigeria or in Africa, marriages in Nigeria particularly before they relocate abroad, the state of the marriage, the state of the relationship before relocating abroad. The question is, what is the state of this marriage? How is the character of the man? How is the character of the woman? What is the foundation of that marriage? How do these people relate? How do they interact? How do they treat each other here in Nigeria before they relocate abroad? You cannot expect a marriage that is toxic, full of violence, full of problems, here in Nigeria to relocate abroad and become the best of it. No. If the fault is from the side of the woman goes there and becomes times two, times three, or times 10 worse than what she used to be, because she would then now take advantage of what the law over there is to the women. Okay? And from the angle of the man, if the man is the culprit here, the abuser here, the one who is not making the marriage or relationship peaceful or blossom, what do you expect now at the end of the day when this person, when this couple travel out? Thing is, if the man or the couple eventually relocate abroad and a man with such character traits travels out and does not bend or turn into a new leaf, he continues in that character. We all know that the laws of marriages in Nigeria is quite different from that in the diaspora. And the laws are bound on the man and the laws are in favor of the women, because women are held in a very high esteem. They are very, very, very respected and catered for. Okay, so tell me now, at the end of the day, what do you expect of a marriage in a nutshell that is not doing well, that is full of crisis, that is at the verge of breaking up, relocating abroad, such people relocating abroad, what do you expect of the marriage to become? That is where the question lies. Having cleared this, when you compare a marriage that is doing well in Nigeria, which is couples who are intentional about marriage, couples that are responsible, that are intentionally making effort to make their marriage and relationship work, they have respect for each other, they have deep love for each other, they have concerns, and if they have children, they love these children so dearly that they take them as their topmost priority. They see each other as their topmost priority and responsibility. They put each other first before any other thing. These are the marriages that at the end of the day will go out there in the diaspora and do better, because what happens? They will continue from where they stopped in Nigeria before relocating abroad. And thereby, you see these couples doing even more better. We have so many of them we see here in Nigeria, or we've seen here in Nigeria before relocating abroad. How, from the picture of what we see, they are doing well in terms of their love life, their relationship, and every other thing. Now tell me, comparing these couples to the opposite of those people we see on the media that will make rounds of toxic marriage, violence, domestic violence, and abuse, what will be the fate of this marriage? It's very easy and self-explanatory. It's easy for you to just depict or picture which one will survive and which one will not survive. Now, looking at the survival risk, you don't need a soothsayer to tell you that couples who are doing well already will stand a better chance to survive than couples who are not doing well, right? And now, to clear the air and doubt about what these men think and what these women believe, the point is, are you a good man? Are you a good person? Are you a good husband? Or are you a good wife before relocating abroad? In order for you to achieve a healthy, smooth, and sweet relationship, you must be intentional about your personality, whom you are, what you represent. Are you a mean and wicked or callous person? Because if you are not a good person, if you are not a good person, like you don't have good personality, everything about you, I sure bet, will be of the opposite. Very bad, very toxic and abusive. Okay? And now bringing it to marriage, how will you give what you don't have? You must be of the perfect character or best character before you can affect the life of your partner, whether a husband or wife, positively. That is the basics. Now, we now understand that it is not a particular trend for women to just intentionally want to travel out or relocate to meet their spouses and become wicked, mean to their partners. It is how these men treat them. And these men fail to understand the fact that they are now in a different place. They are now in a different country. The laws of this country will hold them responsible and accountable of how they live their lives as individuals and as couples. So if you have relocated or you're intending to relocate and you don't know these things, you don't understand these things, you are a man that is abusing your wife, you are a woman that is abusing your husband, it is high time you check these things, check yourself and know if you can survive the heat you're getting here when you relocate. Or better still, you remain here with your toxicity and handle yourself. Because at the long run, when you finally relocate, you are definitely going to shoot yourself in the foot. You are definitely going to expose yourself. Your character and everything will bring you out to the mud. And at the end of the day, you don't have anybody to blame. So it's high time we check our character, which is the key thing that every individual who is in a relationship or marriage should look into, even before getting into marriage or in the course of that marriage, right? So I know that I have been able to clear the point to a large and reasonable extent that it is not in the context of the women or in the character of the women to be very mean. So the whole thing lies in the character of both the man and the woman. So we've come to the end of this video, and I believe by now you have a proper understanding of how these things work and not how it is being speculated on the internet concerning couples who are married here in Nigeria and relocating abroad and making the best or the worst of their marriage. This is to tell us that it all depends on individual differences, character and personality. And if you have watched up till now, I know that you should have your thoughts and opinion concerning these points and this topic we have just treated. Let me know in the comment section and let's continue this conversation from there. And if this is your first time seeing me coming to this channel, please, you're highly welcome. My name is Chivik Inspirations, aka Victoria Chinyere. And here on this channel, we say it as it is, without minding whose heart is God. We say things centered on lifestyle, motivation, and inspiration. You will never get it dull here on this channel. Do well by joining the family as you kindly smash that subscribe button and turn on the post notification bell next to it so that you always be the first to get notified whenever a new video pops up here on this channel. That will be all for now, my lovelies. Remember to always stay happy, stay safe and blessed. Until I'll come up here on this space, but for now, do have a lovely day. Bye.